Many people have a very specific image when they hear the word hacker. You know, they picture someone in a dark room, face lit only by the green glow of a monitor, furiously typing code to break into a bank. It is a myth, you see, a story from movies and TV. This hacker is always a criminal, a shadowy figure working against society for personal gain. The villain behind a digital mask, a modern-day internet outlaw. This image, while dramatic, is dangerously incomplete. The reality is far more nuanced. And more helpful. So welcome to another Nucida video. If you like it, please give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to this channel, and click the bell to never forget our upcoming sessions. If you have any questions or hints, please leave a comment. Our certified QA experts will reply in time. So, who exactly is an ethical hacker? Let's break it down in a simple way. An ethical hacker is a computer and networking expert who is hired by a company or an organization to try and hack into their own systems. The entire purpose is to find security vulnerabilities, weaknesses, or holes in digital defenses. Think of them as finding the open windows and unlocked doors of the digital world. These openings are what a malicious hacker, the criminal kind, could exploit, steal information, cause damage, demand a ransom. The ethical hacker's mission is to find these weaknesses first. They operate with the full permission and knowledge of the system's owner. This is the most important rule. The daily life of an ethical hacker is probably not as action-packed as movies portray, but it is deeply engaging and methodical. A significant portion of their time is spent in the planning and reconnaissance phase. Before they even write a single line of code or launch a scanning tool, they must understand their target. The company's network, its websites, its employees, the types of software it uses. This is all done legally, using public information. Think of it as a detective studying the blueprints of a building, observing the guards' routines, planning a mock heist. Once they have a clear picture of the digital landscape, the testing begins. They exploit a web application's login form, craft a phishing email to trick an employee, gain access to one part of the network and pivot deeper. A huge part of their job is documentation. Every step they take, every tool they use, every vulnerability they find. After the testing phase is complete, they compile all this information into a comprehensive report. When you imagine an ethical hacker's tools, you might think of mysterious, complex programs with scrolling green text. While some tools are indeed sophisticated, the core idea behind them is usually quite simple. An ethical hacker's toolkit is like a digital version of a master locksmith's kit. It contains instruments designed to probe, test, and identify weaknesses. One fundamental tool is the network scanner. Nmap, for example, is like knocking on every door and window of a digital house to see which ones are open, closed, or locked. Then it gives a map of the network. Another essential category is the vulnerability scanner. Automated programs check systems against massive vulnerability databases. Think of it as a building inspector with a checklist. They look for things like outdated software, weak default passwords, and common configuration mistakes attackers exploit. For web apps, hackers use suites like Burp Suite and OWASP Zap. They act as a middleman between browser and server, letting hackers intercept, view, and modify data in transit. But tools don't make the hacker. The most important tool is the hacker's brain, curiosity, creativity, and problem solving. Section 5. Methods of the Masters. One of the most well-known methods used by ethical hackers is penetration testing, often called pen testing. This is the simulated attack we have been talking about. It is a goal-oriented exercise where the hacker tries to achieve a specific objective, like gaining access to a sensitive database or taking control of a critical server. It is the digital equivalent of a fire drill. It tests not just the alarms, the detection systems, but also the response of the people involved. A pen test provides a realistic measure of how well an organization's security holds up against a determined and skilled attacker. Another common method is vulnerability scanning, which is a bit different from pen testing. While a pen test is a deep, focused attack, vulnerability scanning is a broad, automated process. It uses tools to sweep across an entire network, a series of websites, to identify potential weaknesses from a known list. This is more like a general health checkup. It might not find the most clever or complex vulnerabilities, but it is excellent at finding common misconfigurations and unpatched software. The results of a vulnerability scan often provide the initial clues that a penetration tester will investigate more deeply. Ethical hackers also test the human element of security through a method called social engineering. This is the art of manipulating people into giving up confidential information. Being an ethical hacker is not a free-for-all. It comes with a very strict set of rules and a strong ethical code that separates them from criminals. The single most important rule is to always have explicit written permission before starting any testing. This is the bright line that cannot be crossed. Without a signed contract that clearly defines the scope of the engagement, any attempt to access a system is illegal, regardless of intent. This legal document, often called a scope of work, protects both the hacker and the client. It ensures everyone is on the same page about what is being tested and what is off limits. Within that contract, the scope of the engagement is clearly defined: systems, networks, applications, and which ones must be left alone. The scope also sets the timeline for the test and outlines the rules of engagement. Adhering to the scope is non-negotiable. Straying outside of it is both unprofessional and a breach of contract. Confidentiality is another cornerstone of the ethical hacker's code. They must not share this information with anyone outside of the designated contacts at the client company. After the engagement is over, they are required to securely delete any sensitive data they may have temporarily stored. Finally, the guiding principle is to do no harm. If they discover a critical vulnerability, they often have a protocol to report it immediately, rather than waiting for the final report. Let's look at a simple, real-world example. Imagine a small online store that sells handmade jewelry. The owner built the website herself using a popular e-commerce platform. Business was great, but she worried about the security of her customers' payment information. She decided to hire an ethical hacker to perform a pen test on her site. The hacker began by probing the website. He soon discovered a small flaw in the checkout page's code. That flaw allowed an attacker to inject a tiny piece of malicious script into the page. This technique is called cross-site scripting, XSS. This seemingly minor flaw had major consequences. A real attacker could have stolen credit card details of every customer who purchased. The ethical hacker did not steal any data. Instead, she documented the vulnerability and took screenshots to show exactly how it worked. She wrote a clear, non-technical explanation for the shop owner. The report included the specific lines of code to fix. The owner, with a developer's help, patched the hole within a day. For a small fee, she avoided a catastrophic data breach that could have destroyed her business and reputation. Here is another story. A medium-sized school district feared for student data privacy. They had thousands of records with sensitive information. They hired an ethical hacking firm to test the entire network. During the social engineering phase, hackers sent a phishing email to all teachers. The email pretended to be from IT. It announced a new, mandatory security update and linked to a fake login page. Over 30% of teachers clicked and entered credentials. This revealed a massive human vulnerability. With those passwords, hackers could access student grades, medical records, contact information. The report did not name teachers who fell for it. The district implemented recurring training and enabled two-factor authentication. The test changed the security culture of the organization. Becoming an ethical hacker does not require you to be a reclusive genius who has been coding since they were 5 years old. The most important trait is actually a deep and persistent curiosity, enjoys taking things apart to see how they work, loves solving complex puzzles, not easily discouraged by failure. A strong foundation in computer networking is essential. Understand how data travels across the internet, what protocols like TCP do, what IP does, how servers communicate, how clients communicate. A good grasp of operating systems like Linux and Windows is also fundamental. Develop a broad range of technical skills, learning a scripting language like Python, automating repetitive tasks, writing custom tools. Study web applications, understand how they are built, common vulnerabilities like the OWASP Top 10. Mobile application security is a rapidly growing field. Technical skills alone are not enough. Strong communication skills are critical. And verbal. Training and certification can formalize your knowledge. Start with CompTIA Security Plus, Certified Ethical Hacker, CEH, Offensive Security Certified Professional, OSCP. Hands-on practice, in safe, legal environments, Hack the Box, Try Hack Me, Virtual Labs with Vulnerable Machines, Capture the Flag competitions. Cybersecurity constantly evolves. Commit to lifelong learning. Stay curious, read security blogs, follow researchers on social media, always be ready to learn about the next technology and its weaknesses. Keep learning, and, you know, keep practicing. As we look toward the future, it is clear that our world is only becoming more connected, not less. It is not just our computers and phones anymore. Now our cars, our refrigerators, our medical devices, and our home security systems are all connected to the internet. This explosion of the Internet of Things creates an incredible amount of convenience, but it also creates an exponentially larger attack surface for malicious actors. Every one of these new devices is a potential doorway into our networks and our lives, and each one needs to be secured. This means the demand for ethical hackers is set to skyrocket. The role of the ethical hacker is also evolving. It is no longer enough to just test a product for security flaws after it has already been built. Companies are realizing it is far more effective and less expensive to build security in from the very beginning. This has led to the rise of DevSecOps, a culture where security is integrated into every stage of the software development lifecycle. Ethical hackers are becoming crucial advisors in this process, working alongside developers to help them write more secure code and design more resilient systems from the ground up. They are shifting from being just testers to being essential collaborators and educators. Ethical hackers play a vital role in building and maintaining trust in our digital society. Every time you bank online, share a photo, or use a navigation app, you are placing your trust in the security of the systems behind it. High-profile data breaches erode that trust. The work of ethical hackers is a powerful antidote to this. By proactively finding and fixing flaws, they help companies protect their customers, maintain their reputation, and demonstrate a genuine commitment to security. In conclusion, ethical hackers are the guardians of our digital age. They have moved out of the shadows of myth and into the bright light of a respected and critical profession. They are the problem solvers and protectors who use their powerful skills for good, finding the cracks in our digital walls so we can seal them shut. We should respect their work and also take a page from their book by learning a little more about our own digital security. Simple actions like using strong, unique passwords and enabling two-factor authentication can make a huge difference. The world needs more people with the skills and ethics to keep us safe. And for those who are curious, the path to becoming one of these digital defenders is open and more important than ever. Right, so, yeah. Consider learning a bit more about your own security. If you like it, please give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to this channel, and click the bell to never forget our upcoming sessions. If you have any questions or hints, please leave a comment. Our certified QA experts will reply in time or even produce a separate video about your topic. Please also check out our other over 200 videos about software quality. Happy testing. See you next time.